Standing for over 100 years in downtown Oklahoma City, the Skirvin Hotel has many, many stories that have taken place within its walls. Built in 1911 by W.B. Skirvin, the hotel has 225 guest rooms, a basement, and 13 total floors. In the early days of Oklahoma City, rapid population growth was taking place. Industrial companies and construction jobs were in huge abundance, creating a strong, vibrant, and fast-paced economy. With such an economy, businessmen and politicians were also in abundance and needed an appropriate place to stay overnight. But what would such an old place like this be without a story of its haunting? Indeed, a tale exists about a dark entity living in the Skirvin Hotel. I used to have demons in my room at night. Desire, despair, desire. The legend tells of a story of Mr. Skirvin having an affair with one of his employees, a maid who serviced the 10th floor of the hotel. As a result of this, the maid became with child. Worried that a scandal would break out, Skirvin locked this woman in a guest room on the 10th floor. After delivering the child in the guest room, the maid decided she could not go on like this. Holding the child, she jumped from the 10th floor, falling to her death. Still to this day, staff members and guests alike complain of strange things happening at the hotel, such as being able to hear the laughter of the maid, and even sometimes, her child's cries for help.
Hello guys, we're here at the Skirvin on the 10th floor. We're attempting to do a ghost hunt to capture some EVPs or possibly an apparition of the ghost Effie that supposedly haunts the 10th floor of the Skirvin. We'll keep you posted throughout the hunt.
Wow, this thermal camera works really great. I can see everything. Oh, what was that? Was that a person? Well, I think I just got something.
We're about to attempt a EVP session here to see if we can contact Effie. Effie, of course, is the female that was pregnant and had the baby and was confined to the 10th floor to Skirvin. We're going to try to make contact with her or her child to see if there's any evidence of them haunting the Skirvin. Effie, why did you decide to take your life and take the life of your child?
Hi guys, I just want to introduce our actress. Her name is Hannah Sides. She played the ghost or the apparition of Effie in the thermal hit. So, of course, it wasn't a real thermal hit, and this is proof right here. As I just wanted to let you know what we used to make our video. The EVP of the baby crying is actually just a clip that I downloaded off the internet and kind of lowered the volume on. And as far as the thermal hit that we got, this is actually an app that I got that I downloaded on the phone for free. I used it, just took a picture of our friend. She played the part of Effie, the apparition. So just wanted to give you guys a heads up on it, okay?
This threat, though, comes from off the court. Fox 25's Jacqueline Schultz tells us how a hotel ghost story left some really big players really scared tonight. She is live, Jacqueline.
Andrew and Jamie, the Thunder's win against the Knicks last night may have been secured here at the Skirvin. They say they got no sleep while staying here because they feared something may have been watching. Winter Tale. Harrowing haunts at the Skirvin Hotel, the legend of someone or something disturbed some famous guests.
Where'd he come from?
None other than the New York Knicks, who lost to the Thunder Monday night. Some of the Knicks players told the New York Daily News they didn't get much sleep at the Skirvin. Forward Jared Jeffries says it's scary.
Guys from New York, huh? Scared of ghosts.
It's an excuse, you know, or that's what it sounds like.
I just don't think they were as good as the Thunder.
For three.
Knicks center Eddie Curry had his room on the 10th floor, the haunt of the supposed ghost. He says, that's why I spent most of my time in Nate Robinson's room. I definitely believe there are ghosts in that hotel.
Come on, you having another athlete jumping into another man's room? I don't think they should say that, admit that too loud.
Even the Thunder's general manager chimed in.
I mean, some locker rooms are really small and really hot.
But the tale can send some shivers down your spine.
Legend has it, a hotel maid named Effie had an affair with the owner, Mr. Skirvin, became pregnant, then met an untimely death.
Legend says she was locked away in the room. Then she eventually threw herself and her baby off the 10th floor. And according to the website Legends of America, she propositions male guests.
That sounds really appealing. I don't know why those guys would want to leave.
I'm on the 6th floor, so maybe I need to have to be moved.
There is no ghost, it's folklore.
Skirvin General Manager John Williams says there's no records a woman named Effie even existed. Now he's concerned the scare will hurt business from other teams.
This is the first time we've had this problem.
Others say, no way.
If they call me a Swede or something, I'd definitely stay.
Are you going to put teams on the 10th floor in the future?
We absolutely will.
And he says the Knicks, well, just had a bad night.
They just need to score a few more points and worry about Kevin Durant and the rest of the guys, not the ghost.
The Knicks did not return our calls for comment. The general manager of the Skirvin says that the Knicks did not mention any problems about ghosts while they were here, and there are 15 other NBA teams that stay while they play the Thunder here, and they say they've never mentioned any problems while they were here at the Skirvin. Reporting live, Jacqueline Schultz, Fox 25 News.
I'm going to use that when I have a bad day sometime. Oh, it's just haunted. While the Thunder play the San Antonio Spurs, win.
We all like stories, especially that most exciting and mysterious one. So when we hear it, our brains process it and are memorizing unconsciously and consciously, regardless we believe it or not at the moment. Sometimes, the story is not the real story, or we misuse the story into it, and then we also misinterpret it. The wrong scientific theory into a story. Such in the Skirvin Hotel cases, quantum physics and psychology split. And the Skirvin Hotel story is all starting at 10th floor. And all, why in 10th floor? Because the Skirvin's AV jumped from 10th floor. we all know about Effie's story, but is it real? Is it true? Is that story didn't make use from other story? Actually, the story did made it from. So, the Skirvin Effie, the story is true? According to Oklahoma Paranoid News, mentioned a local historian, Ms. Hudson's investigation, she claimed several ghosts of the Skirvin was based on incidents occurring much earlier in Oklahoma City histories, such as in the 1904, there was a keeper of the body house on West 2nd Street who was killed by her husband by the name of the Effie Fisher. And an Effie story also misused from the tale of the Golden Hotel in Nevada. Two stories were similar. They both named Effie. They both the mysteries. They both have the affair with owner. They both pregnant. They both imprisoned in the hotel. But the Effie in the Golden Hotel of Nevada, she died because of abortion. But the Skirvin Effie was enough. Since all the story begin at 10th Force, let's check out the 10th Force. You can see, at first you can see the 10th Force is really bright and a lot of refract objects like mirror painting, but it's also pretty standard. Our impressed memory may influence on our perception when we in the hotel and also mislead our visual illusions toward to a wrong conclusion. So when you're in the hotel, our sensation and perception will become super sensitive, and the opposite is also misleading about our impressive expressive memory. As some people say, they have been watched when they are in the shower or they feel particularly cold in temples during the night.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Hi. We are UCL Pseudoscience team, and then we come here to talk about haunting story about the Skirvin Hotel, and basically the purpose of our hotel, purpose of our project is basically about the pseudoscience, and we try to prove that the Skirvin Hotel is not haunted. Mm-hmm. So thank you for doing a short interview with us.
There's no haunting story associated
really?
With this hotel.
Okay. So, do you want to talk about a little bit about the hotel thing?
Well, we have nothing to talk about. There's no haunting story about this hotel.
That's it.
Okay. So the actor that we, or actress that we have playing the part of the executive assistant really was not an employee of the hotel because of policy against a haunting in the hotel. They just, it's not good for business, I guess. But these two, Carson and Willia, were actually witnesses to the thing.
Yeah, we went down here and talked to her, and she said she wanted to do an interview with us, but and afterwards she said, no, we cannot do it because the hotel policy. So that's why we asked another lady to cover our face, but we are actually the witnesses. What she said exactly previously, that he said, yeah, she said the hotel is not haunted or something.
Now, Carson, you actually have some evidence of that, her saying she would do it, correct?
Yes, while we were standing in the lobby talking with her, I had my iPhone recording just to pick up anything and make sure that we got all the details down, just in case she went ahead and started to let us kind of interview her a bit. And all she really said to us was that the hotel is not haunted and that she would be willing to do an interview with us, but then with subsequent contact, she just said that she wasn't available.
Right.
So.
Yeah, it kind of makes sense.
We pretty understand their situation, their concerning about hunting story, but it's the only thing we're thinking, same thing like that's why a lot of rumors outside still believe the Skirvin's hunting. I think that's with their attitude, avoiding attitude, not talking about it, also caused that reason why everybody's, you know, believe this.
Yeah, so basically you're saying that because they're not wanting to debunk any of those rumors, there's more rumors are being caused and keep going because of that reason.
Because
totally actually, you can tell that actually because we actually contact with them and then we have any, like, no individual, yeah, but that's really, you can see that they're avoiding attitude about the hotel, about this part of the story. That's
right.
Yeah, the rumor never ending and everybody's still believing this hotel is haunted.
Yeah, so.